Hello friends, myself Siddharth Chauhan, welcome to Easy Medicam. So this part of the video is a continuation lecture on the topic of human digestive system. So we were studying about the human digestive system. Human digestive system. Part 2. So in the previous section of the video of this part, we had covered about the oral cavity. So let's continue about the oral cavity. The oral cavity or mouth is responsible for the intake of food, and it is lined by the stratified squamous and keratinized covering. So the oral cavity, it is lined by the stratified squamous oral mucosa. Okay, this we have to remember. What's the epithelium of the oral cavity? It is a stratified squamous oral mucosa. With keratin covering, those areas subject to the significant abrasions such as the tongue, hard palate and roof of the mouth. Mastication refers to the mechanical breakdown of the food by chewing and chopping action of the teeth. The tongue, a strong muscular organ, manipulates the food bolus to come in contact with the teeth. It is also for the sensing organ of the mouth for touch, temperature, taste, using its specialized sensor known as the papilla, which are present on the tongue surfaces. Insalivation refers to the mixing of the oral cavity content with the salivary gland secretions. The mucin, which is a glycoprotein in the saliva, act as a lubricant. The oral cavity also plays a limited role in the digestion of the carbohydrates. The enzyme serum amylase, which is present in the secretions of the salivary gland, a component of the saliva, starts the process of digestion of the complex carbohydrates. The final function of the oral cavity is absorption of the small molecules such as glucose and water across the mucosa. From the mouth, food passes through the pharynx and esophagus via the action of the swelling. Generally, there are three pairs of the salivary glands which are present in the oral cavity. So, the salivary glands are three in number. The salivary glands are three in number. 1, 2, and 3. There are three pairs of salivary glands communicate with the oral cavity. Each is a complex gland with the numerous acinies lined by the secretory epithelium. The acini secretes their content into the specialized duct. Each gland is divided into a smaller segment called the lobes. Salivation occurs in response to the taste, smell, or even appearance of the food. Okay. This occurs due to the nerve signal that tells the salivary glands to secrete saliva to prepare the moisture in the mouth. Each pair of the salivary glands secretes the saliva with slightly different composition. So we are having three pairs of salivary glands. The first one is the parotid gland, which is a salivary gland. Parotid gland. Second one is a sublingual gland. And third one is a submandibular gland. Okay. Submandibular gland is present. So the first one is a parotid gland. The parotid glands are the large, irregular shaped glands located under the skin on the sides of the face. They secretes, first one is the parotid gland. Okay, second one we'll be studying about the sublingual gland. And the third one is the submandibular gland, isn't it? सब मैंडिबुलर ग्लैंड। पैरोटिड सबलिंगुअल एंड द सब मैंडिबुलर। ओके वी आर स्टडिंग ईच ऑफ दिस इंडिविजुअली। द फर्स्ट वन इज द पैरोटिड ग्लैंड्स and it is a large irregular shaped glands located under the skin on the side of the face. So they are present on the side of the face. Okay. They secretes 25% of the saliva. So the 25% of the saliva is being secreted by the parotid gland. 25% of saliva is being secreted by this gland. These glands, okay? They are situated below the zygomatic arch, which is a cheekbone, and cover part of the mandible lower jawbone. And enlarged parotid glands can be easier felt when one clenches their teeth. The parotid produces a watery secretion which is also rich in protein. Immunoglobulins are secreted, help to fight the microorganisms, and the amylase protein starts to break down complex carbohydrates. Next one is the submandibular gland. The submandibular gland secretes 70% of the saliva in the mouth. So the submandibular gland will secrete these glands. Will secrete 70% of the saliva. So the major part of the saliva is being secreted by the submandibular gland. They are found in the floor of the mouth. So where they are found? They are found in the floor of the mouth. On the floor of the mouth. Okay, in the groove along the inner surface of the mandible, these glands produces a more viscous secretions which is rich in mucin and with a smaller amount of proteins. What is mucin? The mucin is a glycoprotein that act as a lubricant. The third one is a sublingual gland, or the third last part of the salivary gland is a sublingual gland. The sublingual glands are the smallest salivary glands. This we have to remember. These are the smallest salivary glands. These are the smallest salivary glands and covered a thin part of tissue at the floor of the mouth. They produce approximately 5% of the saliva, and the secretions are very sticky due to the large concentration of mucin. They are responsible for 5% of saliva. The main function are to provide the buffer and the lubrications. So these are the salivary glands which is present in the mouth or the oral cavity. Next we have to concern about the esophagus, or the next part of the human digestive system which we will be covering about. These are the esophagus. So the esophagus is a muscular tube of approximately 75 cm in length and 2 cm in diameter. What is the esophagus? Esophagus is a muscular tube. First we have to remember that it is a muscular tube. The length is 25 cm and the width is 2 cm in diameter. Okay, It extends from the pharynx to the stomach after passing through an opening in the diaphragm. The wall of the esophagus is made up of inner circular and the outer longitudinal layer of the muscles. So the muscles which are present in the esophagus are two in number. So the muscles are which are present in the esophagus are two, which are inner one is the circular muscle and the outer one is the longitudinal muscle of the muscle that are supplied by the esophagus nerve plexus. This nerve plexus surrounds the lower portion of the esophagus. The esophagus functions primarily as a transport medium between the compartments. So what for the esophagus is? So the esophagus, it is for transportation. So the esophagus is up to this. We'll be covering about the esophagus from the next section of the video. So guys, that's all for today's part of the video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel and press bell icon for more notification. And please like, share and subscribe Easy Medicam and press bell icon for more notification.